What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. Tracee Ellis Ross, as a person, gets a lot of views on YouTube. I don't know why people like to hear more about her, but she's an interesting story. Definitely talented, producer, daughter of Diana Ross. She's still trending in the professional world. And again, I don't have no problem with black women doing very well in the private sector because my mom was doing very well in the private sector. And I think it's great. But the issue that I'll take umbrage with is when a lot of these ladies will start to discuss the situation of, you know, I wish I could have got married, but I didn't find anybody suitable for marriage. You'll hear that trope out there. And, you know, I kind of feel like I'm too old to have babies. But now, you know, like complaining about the fact that you didn't get married, but at the same time saying that you could never find a man. It's just completely ridiculous because Tracee Ellis Ross is a good looking lady. And you've had every opportunity to find somebody, but you're just out here capping all the time, trying to make the men look bad, in particular black men look bad, as if they're incompetent and there's no good men out there, when you've had access to I don't know how many men since you've been in the industry. But Tracee Ellis Ross has been taking some interesting photos on social media for a woman who's not interested in marriage and not trying to be with somebody, right? And there's a brother on TikTok that I found to talk about this in a very interesting way. What I'd like to do is to play this clip, and then I'm going to come back.
Listen, I woke up this morning, and the Lord put Tracee Ellis Ross on my mind. I said, why Miss Tracy, Lord? You know? And I remembered. She got that thing. She got the yams. I looked. I said, Jesus Christ. I already knew it was back there. I already knew it was there like a pop quiz. I already knew. But then, you know, I had to remind myself. You see the abundance. Hold up, let me. I wish I was TSA. I swear to God she's smuggling. I swear she's smuggling. This ain't no harassment or nothing. She just caked up. Her and her mama fine.
So, guys, you've heard that clip, all right? Now, number one, I didn't know she was caking like that, all right? I didn't know who she was caking like that, right? But she does look nice. So that even makes it worse. Because I was talking to a brother, I won't call his name, and he was talking about ladies like Superhead Amber Rose. How do women who look like them, and in the black community, you have a unique opportunity in black America. Why is that? Because you're light-skinned. You're light-skinned, okay? So now, if you're light-skinned, how do you not have men wanting to be with you? Now, think about Tracee Ellis Ross. She's caking it, right? You're light-skinned and you're caking it. So what kind of woman do you have to be to where a man don't want to wife you? Let's count the ways. You would have to be extremely combative, annoying, not trustworthy, have bad judgment. You'd have to be to look like Tracee Ellis Ross and to not find, and let's look at it, her dad is white. You're not married to a black man or a white man. So that means you would have access to both, and easy access because of who your mom was. Your mom is the legendary Diana Ross. So how come you can't get it together? Let me count the ways. Because there's something that's severely wrong there. And that severity is not all men's fault. And my question also is, who are you taking these pictures for, boo? Like, I get that you're working with something, and I definitely appreciate it, because I didn't even know you had it like that. But who are you trying to impress? Who are you trying to get clout from? Do you want to talk about it? I mean, that's what I would like to know. And ultimately, what you will find out is that the people that she's trying to get clout from are the kind of men that ain't good for relationships. That's what a lot of folks don't want to talk about. A lot of the photos that you see women taking on social media, showing off what they look like and what they got, It's very temporary. How many times do men gotta tell women, like, that's not what's gonna get anybody to take you seriously? It looks nice that you have all of that. It's great. I mean, salute that you have a nice body. I mean, I think that's awesome. What does that have to do with the kind of woman that you should be or that you should become? Because that's ultimately what we're dealing with. We're dealing with that. We're not dealing with anything else. We're dealing with that. And a lot of folk don't want to talk about that because it's a lot of ladies out there that have a backside or that have a nice face or have a nice body and have a nice income. But relatively what you're going to understand, again, as this thing keeps getting deeper and deeper, is that number one, women do not understand what men are looking for. And number two, many women just are not interested in what men are caring about or looking for. They're only caring about what a man can do for them, but you're not caring about what you can do for a man. And this tends to be a very big problem, especially in Black America. So now we're not talking about that. Well, then why are we not talking about that? And then when you found out that, you know, what you have to offer is not what's going on, then all of a sudden I couldn't find a guy on my level. So what was a man supposed to do? A man was supposed to basically not care about himself. He was not supposed to take himself seriously. He was supposed to deny his own personal needs and outcomes in his short time here on earth and only be living to suffice what you want and not ever give a damn about what he wants. That's what happens when we really deal with a lot of ladies today in today's world. What they're looking for, and this might not be every woman, but it definitely seems to be the case. Deny your own personal needs, suffice a woman's needs, and you should be okay with that. And if you're not a man willing to do that, then ain't no real men out here. And then you don't see, where's the reciprocity at? And you know, the man giving you something, and then you in turn providing the man something. Hopefully something of value. And what is of value? Not what you're willing to give, what he feels should you be willing to give, or you should be willing to give. That's something that we should be talking about. But ultimately, we don't talk about that. That's the problem. Fundamentally, that's the problem. And whenever we're dealing with that, it's always the man's fault. But then let's go to Instagram and let's take these photos. Let's show off the backside for men that would be interested in, you know, largely what I would consider situationships and nothing very serious. And then let's complain about those guys after we can't do any better because those guys are no good for us. It makes absolutely no sense. And it continues to not make any sense. But guys, what do you think? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. I appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe, hit the bell. We're out.